Hey guys, what's up? It's Cort. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a book unhaul for you guys. Honestly, I'm in a really great mood. It's like 5:30 on a Friday. My day's been pretty good. I got some really exciting news and yeah, I'm just really stoked. Today I'm going to be doing a book unhaul. Yes, ma'am? Pumpkin? The queen herself, everybody. Pumpkin. Anyways, like I was saying, today we are going to be doing a book on haul. Two reasons for this. One being we have some exciting news. I may possibly be moving in the near future. And two, not as exciting news, I hoard books, okay? I just have accumulated a mass amount of books, and I understand why. So the past year, when I dabbed my feet into this bookish community, I was experimenting and seeing what genres, what authors, what tropes I liked. And some I just don't. Some I panic bought and was like, yeah, I'll try that out. And then I just never got around to it, lost interest. I have a lot of books. We're getting rid of some. So let's get into it. I have a brown bag full of them because I thought I would be able to fit them all in a brown bag. But there's actually like enough to fill two bags of books. All right, first up, we've got Chocolate Kisses. This is a book that I thrifted when I wanted to do like Valentine's Day themed reads, but it's actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 short stories within this book, and I'm just not interested in reading it. I feel like when February and Valentine's Day rolls around again, I'm gonna be so excited for like new emerging romances from like authors I know versus this one that I picked up at the thrift store just because purely the concept of a Chocolate Kisses themed Valentine's Day read. Next up, we have Telegraph Avenue by Michael Chabon. And I have seen this book at so many thrift stores. I actually thrifted this book, shocker. I've seen this book at so many other thrift stores, and was this popular back in the day? I don't know. I got this after I read Daisy Jones and the Six because it had a similar vibe, but I've never once been intrigued to pick it up and actually read it. So I'm going to add this to the other editions that are also at the thrift store. Then we have The Perfect Couple by Aline Hildebrand. Here's the thing. I keep buying this author's books and not reading them. I feel like I hear good things about them and I'm like, oh, I know her, I'll buy them. And I don't read them. I think they're just not something I'm interested in. I don't know for sure, I've never read them, but I don't feel the need to pick them up and read them. So I need to stop thrifting them, I need to stop buying them, and I need to donate a couple of them. Then we have Leah Remini's Troublemaker, and I was so stoked when I bought this literally like 2 weeks ago. I've always tried to watch her docuseries and then just gotten distracted, haven't been able to finish it. So I bought the book and I thought that the book would be easier to digest and quicker to get through, and thus I haven't read it. I think actually the docuseries will be more interesting. So I just want to see the videos and pictures and things versus reading about it. Like, this is actually a like true life story of her and Scientology, so I was wrong. I'm gonna watch the show. Then we have The Lost Girls. This is a book that my mom got me for summer. I believe she read it and then she wanted me to read it. But here's the thing, my mom doesn't read any of my books that I give her or recommend. Outside of Daisy Jones and the Six, she did read that and she didn't like it, so outside of that, all of the books I've recommended to my mom, she hasn't read, and I understand because my genre taste is not her genre taste, so I don't feel guilty not reading this and donating it. Mom, if you're watching this, I'm surprised you're watching my videos, but you didn't see me donate this. We also have The Thursday Murder Club by Richard Osmond, Monty Poldies and the Vineyards of Etna, All the Missing Girls by Megan Miranda, and Second Chance Summer by Jill Shalvis. We've got another stack. And this is the second stack of books to go through that I am unhauling. We've got the Saturday Night Ghost Club, which I was super stoked when I found this at Barnes & Noble. It was their $5 Barnes Starbucks cafe book. If you buy a drink, you can get the $5 book that's like on the counter, and I got it. I've realized it's a kid's chapter book. It's a little young for me, so I'm gonna give it to somebody who will enjoy it of the correct age. Then we have The Overstory by Richard Powers, and I bought this when I had taken a trip to the Redwoods, and I was really stoked, I was really excited, and after I read the back, I was not as excited. It's about students and trees and a professor. It's supposed to be very academic and school-related, educational from what I understand, I'm just, I don't know. I think I can donate this one too. Then I have again another collection of like short stories. This is an Agatha Christie. I was so pumped when I found this at the thrift store, but I think there is a reason that it was at the thrift store. This is 50 short stories by Agatha Christie, and it is chunky. So I'd rather read some of her smaller reads, and then if I like it, I'll get something big like this again. But at this moment, I haven't read any of her work or been intrigued to read any of her work, so I'm certainly not going to spend this much time on her work. Then I have another Agatha Christie book, but when I thrifted this, I did not realize it was an adapted version, and therefore I just don't feel like I need to read it. I don't know. It is what it is. I also have the book In 5 Years by Rebecca Searle, and when I read One Italian Summer a couple years ago, thank you, that book got me back into my reading jam. I loved it. So I saw this at a thrift store and I was like, that's my favorite author. I'm going to read that book and be so excited I got that book. And then I never read the book. Also, my cousin said that this book is very sad, and I don't usually read sad books, so I think we're gonna donate it. Another Aline Hildebrand book, this is Hotel Nantucket. Here's the thing, I talk about this book all the time. I've had it for like 3 years. I've never read it. Next we have I'll Be There But I'll Be Wearing Sweatpants. This book is about two friends navigating adulthood and children and family and also finding friendships along the way and how realistically hard that can be. I did start reading it and I highlighted it, but I never continued it. I don't know, maybe it made me sad, maybe it was too relatable. I feel like this book would be really good for some people, but I just never finished it. Then we have Bookish People by Susan Call, and I was really excited for this book as too. I was excited for every one of these books, you know? I just never reached for it. I feel like I found other bookish books that I'm more intrigued by. So also this had a low rating on Goodreads. So hasta la vista, baby. Then we have Every Value Break by Peter Swanson. I thrifted this years ago. This was like one of the first books that I thrifted. I just never read it. Girl in Pieces by Kathleen Glasgow. Well-known book. Just haven't read it. It says hauntingly beautiful. I don't know. Maybe it's not hauntingly beautiful for me. It could be. I just didn't read it. And I don't want to. Then we have Dog Days. This is a poetry book and it was super cute when I bought it. It has like illustrations of dogs. I just have not read poetry ever since I started reading like novels and stories. So it hasn't gotten much love, but it's literally like a brand new book. Then we have this book. This is Merry Bloody Returns, Tales of Birthdays with Bite. I bought it because I thought it would be spooky and I just kind of feel like it's childish. So we're gonna get rid of it. And then I have two more books. We have Something in the Water and 26 Kisses, and I'm just gonna donate these, simple as that. And those are all the books that I will be unhauling. Let me know if you like this video. Let me know if there's any books that I should not, in fact, unhaul. If you saw the book and you're like, no, you need to read that, let me know down below. I'll read the comments before I get rid of these. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll talk to you guys in my next video. Bye guys.